Microlecture 27, The New Imperialism in Asia. During the 19th century, Asian societies underwent significant social, political, economic, and cultural changes. During this era, Western imperial powers came to dominate most of the region. These colonies entered the world markets as producers of raw materials. Two nations, Japan and China, were able to resist imperial powers, and at the end of the century, they continued to be politically independent. One of the main places where it is possible to analyze the presence of the new imperialism in Asia is the colonization of India by the British Empire. By 1757, the British East India Company controlled most of India after the decline of the Mughal Empire. In the 19th century, the company was replaced by the British government, which progressively unified the subcontinent and controlled the economy. In 1869, the Suez Canal in Egypt was opened, and the time of the trip between England and India dropped from 6 months to 3 weeks. The development of fast communication networks changed the history of the Indian Ocean. British rule in India was established by implementing cooperation networks with local allies, the disarming of local armies, the introduction of property laws, and the respect for both Hindu and Muslim traditions. The British administrators suppressed some Indian traditions that they believed were uncivilized. They outlawed slavery, suppressed banditry, and designed laws that improved the position of women in society. After 1858, India was ruled by the British Parliament from London and was administered by a local civil service with only British members. Basically, all the members of that bureaucracy were white. In 1900, the bureaucratic elite consists of less than 3,500 officials for a population of 300 million people. The economic impact of the British presence in India was varied. The main products we export from India during British dominations were tea and coffee. To help in the consolidation of these markets, the English crown invests a lot of money in infrastructure, especially trains. By 1900, the railroad network extended 25,000 miles and served 188 million people. Although in general the economy expanded, poor people in the country did not see improvements. Many people did not have land, and sanitary conditions continued to be bad for them. The ones who enjoyed more progress during the British occupation were the middle classes, who could educate themselves within the English language system imposed in the country. High caste Hindus came to form a new elite profoundly influenced by Western thought and culture. Having a well-educated English-speaking elite, a strong bureaucracy and infrastructure helped India create a strong state, which is perhaps the most important colonial legacy. Among other things, this state managed to control the tensions between the Hindu and the Muslim populations. British domination was also characterized by racism, since the top jobs, the best clubs, the modern hotels, and certain railroad compartments were sealed off to brown-skinned people. The defense of India's British possessions was the empire's primary goal in the late 19th century. Their presence there also led to a steady expansion of their control areas in Asia. In fact, between 1852 and 1880, the British annexed the territories that today are Myanmar and Burma. The Europeans also colonized other parts of Asia. After 1799, the Dutch dominated the East Indies, present-day Indonesia, building a robust colonial state. They created a Dutch-inspired education system and a powerful bureaucracy. The French invaded Vietnam in 1859 and later incorporated Laos and Cambodia to create what was known at the time as French Indochina. The French justified their colonialism in the region using Catholicism as the excuse. In all of these three countries, the local rulers were left on their thrones, but France dominated and promoted French culture. In Southeast Asia, only Siam, present-day Thailand, succeeded in preserving its independence. King Chulalongkorn, 1868-1910, knew about Western politics and science and was able to recognize what were the colonists' intentions. He outlawed slavery and implemented modernizing reforms that centralized the government, which helped him resist the Europeans' advance. The United States became an imperialist power in Asia when in 1898 they took the Philippines from Spain within the context of the Spanish-American War. In the Philippines, the US introduced a form of colonial rule that included public works and economic development projects, improved education and medicine, and transformed the state's structure. By the turn of the 20th century, the countries in Asia and the Pacific varied greatly in wealth and power. The impact of colonialism defined their modern history and how they adapt to global conditions after 1850. This is all I have for you today. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.